At 3:30 p.m. local time on December 14, 2025, the ground began to shake back and forth north of San Francisco in California. The earthquake was brief, lasting for only a few seconds, registering in as the magnitude 4.0. Due to its low magnitude, this earthquake was fairly harmless, only causing some items to fall off of shelves and a few houses, with one viewer of mine reporting this happening at their place in Cotati. The only reason there was any form of damage at all was because this earthquake was absurdly shallow, occurring 1.9 miles or 3.1 kilometers below the surface. For reference, most regional earthquakes tend to occur at depths of 2 to 4 times this. To me, this fairly insignificant earthquake is scientifically interesting, as it did not occur on one of the many major fault lines that runs through the area surrounding and including San Francisco. After all, multiple news sources seemingly guessed that the earthquake which struck originated on the lengthy Rogers Creek Hayward Fault. This fault line has produced 2 magnitude 6 range earthquakes and 4 magnitude 5 range earthquakes since 1850, and in a worst case scenario could even technically produce up to a magnitude 7.2 earthquake. However, the Rogers Creek segment of this fault is too far to the west to be the source of this earthquake, which moved the ground almost purely horizontally via what is known as a right lateral strike slip fault. Instead, I interpret that a lesser-known fault system was the source, specifically occurring on what is known as the Bennett Valley Fault Zone. This fault zone accommodates some of the local tectonic stresses not accommodated by either the much larger Rogers Creek or San Andreas faults. And, historically speaking, the Bennett Valley Fault Zone has never produced an earthquake larger than magnitude 4.5, but this doesn't mean it still isn't quite active. In the past 50 years, it has produced hundreds of mostly small magnitude earthquakes, with a magnitude 2 range earthquake about once every 4.7 months, a magnitude 3 range earthquake about once every 40.8 months, and a magnitude 4 range earthquake about once every 25 years. These occurred on a number of subfaults, almost all involving the east side of the fault line moving southward while the west side of the fault moves northwards. The 4.0 quake that struck on December 14th happens to represent the second largest quake known to have struck this fault system, which, by the way, forms a nice exposure on this hillside. While we do not know what the theoretical maximum earthquake this fault line could produce is, my own estimate suggests up to a magnitude 6.0 to 6.3 could be possible, albeit absurdly unlikely. Looking at the aftershock forecast chart, which suggests the statistical odds of various magnitude earthquakes striking in a given time frame following 3:30 a.m. local time in California on December 14th, you can see what I mean. The chance of a magnitude 6 aftershock or higher in the next week is incredibly improbable at 1 in 2,000, while the chance of a magnitude 3 range aftershock striking in the same time span is 35%. The earthquake sequence in question could actually be subdivided in two, as on November 30th, a series of aftershocks following a magnitude 3.3 quake struck 3/4 of a mile away from where the December 12th through present quakes would strike. The first sequence may have led to strain propagation further down in the fault zone, leading to the magnitude 3.3 earthquake potentially triggering the magnitude 4 quake 14 days later. Across these two sequences, a total of 18 earthquakes have occurred. 5 magnitude 1 range quakes, 8 magnitude 2 range quakes, 4 magnitude 3 range quakes, and 1 magnitude 4 range quake. This honestly represents the most seismicity this fault line has produced in several decades at a minimum, and is scientifically interesting, albeit not concerning in my opinion. It just happens to represent one of the numerous local fault lines in this section of California. As a final note, I would like to thank my patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.